Hello everyone, and welcome to the Microsoft Security Update Summary, where I will present a short recap of what was released today, March 11th, 2025. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. I'm going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then I'll dive into a few vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities I'm covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Okay, before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to really get an understanding of how this release stacks up to the previous year. With that, we have 57 newly disclosed vulnerabilities in today's release, and that's quite a bit lower than our average over the past 13 months of just over 91. Next, I'll look at remote code execution vulnerabilities, where there are 23 in today's release. That's also a little bit lower than average of just over 36. Next, I'll move into scoring, where Microsoft uses the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a scoring methodology that allows software and hardware and firmware vendors to be able to compare and contrast different vulnerabilities on the same scale. This scale goes between 0 and 10, where 10 represents the most risk. The highest scored CVE from today's release is 8.8 on that scale of 10, which is quite a bit lower than the average high score over the past year of just over 9.5. Next, I'll talk to the average CVSS score across all of the vulnerabilities in today's release. That comes in at 7.29, which is about a quarter point lower than our average over the past 13 months of just over 7.5. Now, the CVSS score is a great starting point when we talk about risk. As I mentioned, it allows software vendors to be able to compare and contrast across different products, even across hardware and firmware as well, that a 7.3 vulnerability has the same risk regardless of what product it is, whether it's hardware or software. But it's not everything when we talk about what risk factors there are associated to a vulnerability. For example, one thing that's not calculated in a CVSS score is whether or not a vulnerability is publicly disclosed. These are vulnerabilities where one way or another, prior to release, the existence of the vulnerability has been made public. It could be something as extreme as a security researcher publishing proof of concept that it would allow a threat actor to build exploit code, or on the other end of the spectrum, it could be something as simple as a social media post where the finder simply says they found an issue with no details that would inform a threat actor how to build exploit code. This month, we have one publicly disclosed vulnerability, and that's about half of our average over the past 13 months of just over two. Another thing that's not calculated in the CVSS scoring is whether a vulnerability has known to be exploited or not. In this case, this month, we have six vulnerabilities that were known to be exploited at the time of release. That's well above our average of just over 2.3. Now, vulnerabilities are known to be exploited, takes that risk up from just publicly disclosed. Publicly disclosed is more of a theoretical risk a lot of times. It is that the existence of that vulnerability exists out there, but it's not known whether it is being used by threat actors. Vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited are a real risk because in these cases, we have detected threat actors using these vulnerabilities. And so when I talk about risk and the associated risks with a release, this is one of the stats that I really key on because these are real risks and a very good reason to make sure patching is robust and occurs every month. But especially this month with six vulnerabilities known to be exploited out in the wild. All right, next we'll move into our overview chart where we'll start digging into just this release. This month with the Windows products, as I mentioned at the top of the video, the total number of vulnerabilities is lower, so we're gonna see lower counts in some of these things. For example, with Windows, depending on the operating system, we're averaging in the low 50s over the past 13 months for the number of vulnerabilities. This month, we're in the mid 30s, so clearly lower. Now, Office has 10 vulnerabilities, and we've been averaging just under 8 per month over the past 13 months. As we move up the chart, we get into products that are not necessarily serviced every single month. For example, ASP.NET Core and Visual Studio and our developer tools. And then there's a handful of vulnerabilities that fall in the Azure umbrella that are also being serviced this month. The first vulnerability that I will talk to is CVE-2025-24993. This is an important remote code execution vulnerability in NTFS. This one was privately disclosed, but exploitation has been detected out in the wild. This one has a base CVSS score of 7.8. The attack vector is local. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required, but user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. As far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support, whether that's Windows 10 or 11 on the desktop, or Server 2016 through Server 2025 on the Server OS. Next, I'll talk to CVE-2025-24983. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability, privately disclosed to Microsoft, but exploitation has been detected for this vulnerability. The base CVSS score here is 7.0. The attack vector is local. The attack complexity is high. Privileges required is low. And user interaction here is none. A few things I'll point out here is that in order to successfully leverage this, a threat actor would have to win a race condition. That's why the attack complexity is set to high. And as far as what privileges could be gained if a threat actor were able to leverage this, those would be system privileges. I'll also point out that there's detection guidance for this vulnerability as well as the previous one I talked to. And so if you're using Defender, you are protected against these vulnerabilities. That detection guidance has also been shared with our antivirus partners. And so if you're running the latest version of their detections, you should be protected on those as well. And the third vulnerability that I will talk to today is CVE-2025-24035. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 8.1 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is high. Privileges required is none, and user interaction here is none. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this. As far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support, whether that's desktop Windows 10 and 11 or on the server side 2016 through 2025. I'll also point out this vulnerability as well as the previous ones. These are Windows vulnerabilities. Windows updates are cumulative, so there is only one action for you to take on your machines to protect you from these three as well as the other about 30 vulnerabilities depending on the operating system. But one cumulative update installed on your system protects against all of the vulnerabilities that were disclosed today, as well as all the vulnerabilities from previous releases. So there's no need to figure out which KB to install for each individual CVE. It's just one simple package to deploy on your system. If you are a Microsoft Premier or Unified Support customer and you would like to attend the full briefing call where we cover more content and are available to answer questions, you can either work with your customer success account manager to sign you up, or you can sign yourself up in Services Hub. All right, that's all I have for today. I want to thank everyone for taking time to listen to me talk about some vulnerabilities, and I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.